Hello, dear polymer clay enthusiasts. My name is Mihaela, and I have prepared a new project for you to inspire you to work with polymer clay. We are trying again to achieve a faux enamel look, but this time we are going to use Lumiere metallic acrylic paints. This is the perfect project to use your scrap clay because we are going to paint on the back and on the front of the pendant, so you won't get to see much of the polymer clay. I am using, as you can see, scrap clay as well, and I am working with Cernit black polymer clay, but I think you can use the color of your choice because we are going to paint a lot and color a lot the polymer clay, so it doesn't matter what color of polymer clay you choose to use. As you can see, I'm using copper foil, and I am using gilding copper foil. I'm working with sheets of polymer clay that are passed through the pasta machine through a medium setting, and I'm using an Imperia pasta machine. And then I used a copper foil that I pressed gently into the polymer clay, and then I used my finger to make sure that the copper foil is stuck to the polymer clay. Because of the fact that I'm using scrap clay that has inclusions inside, let's say that foil did not adhere to the polymer clay very, very well. So I had to discard larger parts of the of the polymer clay stripes that are decorated with copper foil. But that's okay, because for this project we are going to work with a small length of such polymer clay stripes. So I used the small round ball tool to make a freehand pattern that I wanted to look to give an interesting look to the finished pendant. And I'm working on an idea of a, let's say, primitive inspired pendant, and the shape that I cut with the flexible blade was a freehand shape, and it's, I would say, not a perfect shape. And this kind of shape, along with the this decoration in the middle of the pendant, would give me a primitive look on the finished pendant. At least I hope so. So I'm continuing to cut thin slices of polymer clay. To use them to create a pattern in the middle of the pendant. So as you can see, I'm following the lines. I'm using the craft knife to push the polymer clay foil decorated stripes where I want them to be. Slices, I'm sorry. And then using the etching pearl tool. I created three round copper foil decorated shapes. And then I used my fingers to press them slightly into the polymer clay base. I will make also two small triangles that I will put on top, above and beneath the central design. I don't know, to have an interesting look on the final pendant. And I'm using my my fingers to work a little bit on the shape of the pendant to make it a little more rounder, I would say. And then I'm using the scrap clay from the present project that I will put again through the pasta machine through the medium setting. And I will use this sheet of polymer clay to make a back for my pendant. So it is visible that I used the scrap clay from a project in which I used copper foil. But I think this will look nice on the final design, on the back of the final design. I'm using again my fingers to soften the edges, because I won't be sanding the pieces after baking them, this piece, in fact, after baking it. So I have to make sure that I have neat edges before baking the pendant. I try to texture the back of the pendant with the back of the blade, but it didn't work. So I decided to use a toothbrush to make an organic, rough look on the back of this primitive pendant. I'm using copper Fimo metallic powder to color the edges. And I'm using this copper powder to color the back of the pendant as well. Using a needle or a needle tool, you'll have to poke a hole this, of course, if you don't decide to drill a hole after baking the piece, but I prefer to poke a hole into the raw polymer clay. And also I decided to apply copper mica all over the back to have a very nice back for the finished pendant. There's a second piece, and this is my trial piece. So this is the piece on which I tried my idea, and this is how I've seen that I have to be very careful when applying this mixture of triple thick glaze and Lumiere paints, because it is very it's a little bit trickier not to color the copper design, but you will have to pay attention when you are applying the colors and do your best not to color the design, because you won't have a very nice effect on your finished piece. So as you can see, I am using Americana triple thick glossy glaze, and I mixed a quantity of this kind of glaze with some metallic paint. And I will be using bronze, copper, gold, green to color this side of the pendant. And for this first part, I am going to work with these colors in the same time, because I want the colors to blend, and you will see they do blend, and they blend very really beautifully. So if you want your colors to blend, you'll have to work with them before drying, and in case you want to work on a design but you don't want this blending part, you will have to apply a layer, wait for it to dry, and then apply a second layer, and of course the colors would not blend together. For some areas that are difficult to reach, you might need to use a needle or a needle tool to push to add this mixture of glossy glaze and Lumiere paints. So as you can see, I am adding a generous amount of color, and I've worked with the bronze, copper, and gold. Now it's time to add a little bit of green. And again, I'm using a needle to add some color into difficult spots, I would say. So now it's time to have fun with the colors, to mix them, to add more color, I don't know, to add and mix the colors until you are happy with the look of the piece. It's a trial and an error process, but normally these acrylic metallic paints are very beautiful, so I don't think you can have a result which is not very beautiful, because you are working with beautiful colors and you beautiful colors that blend beautifully together, so you've got a winning combination, I would say. So as you can see, I'm adding a little bit of gold paint because I want to make this part of the design lighter. Next, I'm going to apply some pearlescent violet on the other side, on the other half of the pendant. And again, I'm adding a generous amount of color. And I recommend that you try a little bit this technique and try to mix, I don't know, more glossy glaze and less color, and you'll have more translucent, more translucent mixture, or you can add let's say the same amount of glaze and the same amount of Lumiere paints, and you'll have this kind of liquid colored mixture. I decided to add a little bit of blue inside the spirals because I thought that the center needed to be a little more accentuated to put an emphasis on the center of the piece. And I thought that some blue color would give a balance to the piece. I decided to change the angle because I wasn't sure that I was able to show the process on camera and filming myself, so sometimes I don't know if it is a good angle or not, and I'm trying to experiment different angles to, I don't know, to make better videos for you. In fact, because of the fact, it took some time to color the part, the other half with pearlescent violet, and in the meantime, I would say that these mixed colors are half dry, so as you can see, we don't get a lot of blending between the blue and the colors that are underneath. So if you want this the center color to mix with the underneath colors, you'll have to apply this before working on the other side, and so the colors won't have the time to dry and you'll have the blending effect. And because I wanted to give an impression that the colors did blend, which did not happen, but I wanted to fake it, let's say, I added little spots of blue, and I will work again with copper, bronze, and gold to hide the fact that these were just lines put on top. Again, I'm adding a little bit of gold because I thought that this part, this side was a little bit too dark, and I wanted to have a contrast between the violet and the center and this side of the pendant, which would be lighter in color. It is very difficult to decide when you stop, when you are working with such beautiful colors. And as a finishing touch, I decided to add some, I think this is the bronze, I think, to add a little bit of bronze on the margins to have a very well contoured margin for the pendant. I think it's copper. I'm using again the needle to put little quantities of paint in some areas. So after allowing for the colors to dry and looking at the pendant, I decided to add green line on the right side of the pattern. I thought it lacked the green, and I like green very much, so I wanted to have more green on this piece. So don't forget that you have two possibilities. You can work with the colors while they are not dried yet, they will blend together, or you can apply a layer, wait for the colors to dry, and then apply a second layer on top. These are possibilities that you can use, and I hope that you will make use of them in your work with polymer clay. If you are wondering about the look of the trial piece, in fact, I have added a coat, a layer of Americana triple thick glossy glaze. And this is why it looks like this, because I'm working on the same, on the pendants in the same time. So I let it dry completely. And then I started applying the same kind of triple gloss glaze, Americana triple gloss, triple glossy glaze, triple thick, I'm sorry, triple thick glossy glaze. And again, I'm applying a generous amount all over the pendant. I'm applying a little bit on top of the copper foil covered areas to protect them as well. And you will have to use a transparent varnish and apply it on the sides of the pendant to protect them as well. And when the front of the pendant is fully dried, you can flip it off and use transparent varnish on the back to protect the back as well, because you don't want to have, copper powder on your skin or on your clothes. You have to be very careful to apply the triple thick varnish all over the pendant. And if you see that you have spots where there is not enough glaze, you should add some more in that areas as well. In case you have bubbles, I didn't, but in case you have bubbles, you will just have to use the brush and pull them to the sides. You have to be careful not to put too much glossy glaze, because it might drop off the pendant, and then you'll have to allow for the colors to dry. Then I decided to use some copper wire to make a very simple veil for the pendant. So I'm just putting the copper wire through the hole, and I'm making small loops, and I will make three on one side and three on the other side, and there are kind of loose loops. I'm not pulling the wire all the way. I'm leaving some space between the loop and the pendant. I'm sorry that I'm working off camera. Sometimes I lift the piece too much from my working area, and it gets off camera. And then I used the two ends of the wire. I twisted them together. As you can see, I'm using my hands to twist the two ends together. And then I used cutting pliers to cut the excess wire. And then with the round nose pliers, I inserted this twisted wire inside the hole because I wanted to have a very nice back for the bale as well, and because I didn't want this twisted wire to hurt my skin. And then I just used a copper chain and a lobster closure and some jump rings to finish the design. I hope you liked this project. I hope you find it inspiring. I wanted to remind you that the polymer clay adventure is the place to be if you are in love with polymer clay like I am, and that it's never too late to enroll in this wonderful experience. Thank you for watching my tutorial. I hope you'll press the like button, and I hope you'll stay tuned for more polymer clay tutorials and more inspiration for your work with polymer clay.